Hi children, welcome to our class. Last class we have seen that valency. Okay, today we will see atomic number. The topic atomic number. What do you mean by atomic number? We can see atomic number is the number of protons present in an atom. Atomic number is the number of protons present in an atom. It is the number of protons present, number of protons present in an atom. Okay, in number of protons present in an atom is known as atomic number. Sorry. Number of protons present in an atom is known as actually atomic number of an element, and it is represented by the letter Z. Atomic number of an element is the number of protons present in an atom, and it is represented by the letter Z. Okay. So, suppose if you are given that sodium has atomic number 11 and the atomic number is represented there, if you are writing the symbol of the element, suppose we are writing that sodium there, the left side lower end, lower corner, left side we are writing the atomic number. So, atomic number of the sodium is 11 means sodium contains 11 protons there. The atom of sodium contains 11 protons. And you know atom is electrically neutral, right? So that means the number of protons and the number of electrons are equal. So can you say how many electrons will be there in that sodium? Yes, it is 11. So number of protons and number of electrons are same there. So we can say that if you are getting the number of protons, the you can find out the number of electrons present in that atom. Okay, so we can say that atomic number is either the number of proton or the number of electrons present in an atom, and it is represented by the symbol letter Z. Okay. And we can see now next term, that is mass number. Mass number. Mass number is the sum of number of protons and neutrons present in an atom. Mass number is the number which is the sum of number of protons and number of neutrons. So if you are representing the protons, number of protons P, and if the number of neutrons are number of neutrons, we are representing it by N, then sum of this number of protons and number of neutrons will give you, that is P plus N will give you the mass number. Mass number is number of protons plus number of neutron, and that mass number is denoted by the letter, capital letter A. Okay, so capital letter A gives that mass number, and it is the sum of number of protons and number of neutrons present in an atom. That you know, proton and neutron are present there inside the nucleus, and electrons are revolving around the nucleus, that you know. Okay, so if you know the number of electrons and protons there, you can, if you know the atomic number there, you can calculate the mass number. Mass number is represented by the letter A, and you can suppose the element, suppose an element is X, it can be represented by its atomic number and mass number. Mass number, atomic number is written here in the lower bottom, and mass number is written at the top of the element. Okay, this is the representation of the, this is the representation of the element. So, if you know the atomic number and mass number of an element, we can represent the element there using like this. Suppose if it is sodium, the element sodium, then how will you represent the element sodium? By knowing the atomic number is 11 and mass number is 23 for sodium. So, this is the representation for sodium. By knowing the atomic number and mass number, we can represent the element. Okay, and if you know the mass number, the, suppose you know that chlorine mass number is 35 and atomic number is 17, the calculate the number of neutrons. How will you calculate the number of neutrons? We know that number of proton plus neutron will give you 35. And here from the atmosphere, you know, from the atomic mass, you know, atomic number is number of proton. So, we can say that atomic number is the number of proton. We can say that Z is number of proton is equal to 17. And if you know the number of protons there and mass number also you know, how will you calculate? Yes, A is equal to 17. A is equal to 17 plus N. Okay, from this example you can see that A is equal to 17 plus N. So, A if you know, A here it is written, that is 35 is equal to 17 plus number of neutron. So, number of neutron is equal to 35 minus 17. That will give you the number of neutron. Number of neutron is equal to 35 minus 17. That number will be the number of neutrons there. Okay, so if you know the atomic number and mass number, you can find out the number of protons there, number of electrons there, number of neutrons also. So, once again I am concluding, the atomic number is the number of protons present in an element, and it can be also as the number of protons and electrons are same, equal. So, it can be the number of electrons also represented by the letter Z there. Okay, and mass number is the sum of protons plus neutrons represented by the letter A. And if you know the atomic number and mass number, we can represent the element also. Okay, now we can see few examples for that. Write the electronic configuration of chlorine and draw the structure. Structure drawing we have seen in the last video. And configuration of chlorine. For that you should know the atomic number of chlorine. Atomic number of chlorine is 17. So we can say that atomic number of chlorine is 17. So the electronic configuration is equal to KLM. Like so you can write. First two electrons will go to the K shell. And then 8 electrons will go to the L shell. Then the remaining 7 electrons will go into the M shell. Okay, and based on this we can draw the structure also. If you want to draw the structure of chlorine, first you have to knot the nucleus there. Then first shell is K shell. There you have to knot 2 electrons there. And the second shell, it is L shell there. There are 8 electrons are there. You have to knot all the 8 electrons. And after that, one more shell is there, that is M shell. There you can show 7 electrons. This is how to draw the structure of atom. If you know the atomic number, we can draw the structure. And if you know the atomic number, we can write the electronic configuration there. And if you know the mass number, we can calculate number of all the subatomic particles present inside that particular atom. Okay, then one more next problem we can see. an atom of an element X contains 29 electrons and 30 neutrons. Find its atomic number and mass number. Atom contains 29 electrons. 29 number of electrons is 29. Okay. And electrons, the number of electrons is equal to number of protons. So number of protons is also 29. The and neutrons present there. Neutrons, number of neutrons present there is 30. So what will be its atomic number and mass number? Atomic number of the element Z is equal to number of protons, isn't it? So it will be equal to 29. And mass number of an element A is equal to number of proton plus number of neutron. That is equal to 29 plus 30. So 59. So A is 59. A is 59 and Z is 29. So how will you represent the element there? If you want to represent the element X, 29 and 59. This is the representation of the element 29 and 59. Okay. And now we can see the question once again. How will you represent the element? So first we have seen that atomic number there, and we have calculated the mass number also there. And after that we have represented the element if you know the atomic number and mass number. Now we can see, just go through that. If you understood, you can do so many problems like this. Okay. Now we can move to another question. That question is, atomic number of aluminium is 13 and mass number is 27. So the element is given there as aluminium and atomic number is 13 and mass number is 27. So this is the representation of the atom. Okay. Atomic number is 13 and mass number is 27. Calculate the number of protons, electrons and neutrons in the ion. The question is, in the ion we have to calculate. So first of all, we should know what type of ion will be it forming during reaction. Aluminium, atomic number is 13. So we should know the electronic configuration. The electronic configuration is 2, then 8, then 3 will be the electronic configuration. And if you know the electronic configuration there, we can understand what will be happening during the reaction. When aluminium is undergoing reaction, in order to get that octet configuration there, it will be losing, it is trying to lose that 3 electron to gain that 8 electronic configuration. So 3 electrons it will lose while participating in chemical reaction. So at that time what will happen? Yes, it will lose the 3 electrons. So what is the valency of that element? Yes, valency of aluminium is 3. It will lose 3 electrons. After losing 3 electrons, what will be the ion formed by from this atom aluminium? So after losing 3 electrons, aluminium will be converted into Al3+, right? See, 13 positive and 13 negative charges were there, but from that 3 minus is removed. My negative charges are removing the, so 13 positive and 10 minus only. So net charge will be plus 3. So aluminium will be forming a 3+ ion the. So this is the representation for the ion formed by aluminium while participating in chemical reaction. So we can see the question once again. Calculate the number of electrons, protons and neutrons in the ion. This is the ion. Okay, so we can calculate the number of electron. How many electrons? Number of electrons in aluminium 3+. Just now we have seen how many electrons are the? Yes, it is 10 electrons. Number of protons in Al3+. Aluminium 3+ contain how many protons? 13 protons. No change in proton. Okay. And so the number of electrons also. Number of neutrons. We have to find out the number of neutrons present in aluminium. Number of neutrons. Okay. Will there be any change in the mass number? So, mass number will not change. What was the mass number for aluminium? 27. So, from the mass number, if you are deducting the number of protons, you will get the number of neutron, that is 14. 14 will be the mass number, 10 will be the number of electron, and 13 will be the number of proton present in the ion. Okay. And we can see if any balance is remaining there, represent the atom. How will you represent the atom? This is the representation of the atom. Aluminium, left side we can write the atomic number, and top left side you can write the mass number. What will be the valency of the element? Valency of the element is 3. After losing 3 electron, it will be converted into Al3+. Hope you understood this. Okay, I hope this today's topic is clear to you. Thank you.